Today, I have some another good news that I would like to share with you. It's about your Thailand pass. Oh, this is another good thing about Thailand pass. Anything to do with ease of the regulation of Thailand pass, I count it as a good news. You don't need to do another one, another new Thailand pass if you're still traveling within 7 days. And it's even better, it starts from the 18th of April. Details on this video. Hello everyone and welcome to Sawadee Thailand. Nice to see you and lovely to see you. Really happy. I'm really happy to share you this video about the Thailand Pass. And first of all, wow. I'd like to mention that Thailand Pass, it has been the most hassle and the most difficult to stop tourists and travelers to coming to Thailand. This one right now, day to day, Thai government are eased and all the regulation one by one. They don't want to do whole lot. They don't want to do everything in one go. On my previous video, I have mentioned about they are planning to cancel test and go and Thailand pass on the CCSA meeting 22nd of April. What I'm talking to you now today is 19th of April. In the next couple of days, I will sharing with you the most update whether that plan is going to approve or not. On my previous video, if you have not watched it, so you can take a look and watch the detail up there about the previous video that I have talking when they're going to planning to do the cancel of test and go and Thailand pass. The plan of cancellation is will be on the issue on a meeting on the 22nd of April. This plan will be approved or not. But for the issue that I'm going to share you on this video, you don't need to wait because it already start to affect it from the 18th of April, which is yesterday. Now, what is about it? Yesterday, after the Thailand Pass has been announced and it's been published on the website of the Thailand Pass itself. The Thailand Pass that you're going to apply, this Thailand Pass website only. On this website has making announcement and published that all traveler that you already have existing Thailand Pass and your date of traveler have been changed. So within 7 days. So you don't need to making a new Thailand pass. Oh, this is a good news and it's very, wow. very good news that I would like to share with you. The most difficult thing and the most hassle is the changing the Thailand pass because you have canceled your flight is canceled or maybe you know something accidentally about your personal issue that make you cannot travel. But from now, if your plan are still within 7 days, you don't need to change your Thailand pass. And the only thing that you need to do is you need to change your insurance date because your insurance date must be start from the date of your travel. And also you must change your reservation of the hotel. If you're not changing, they will stick with the same date and they will send you the car to pick you up at the old itinerary. So you need to change everything except the Thailand pass. So make sure that you have the confirmed itinerary, insurance and a hotel with the car and sending the driver to pick you up and accommodation that you need to change according to your flight arrival. And I would like to wrap up everything again about the person who would like to enter to Thailand. If you are fully vaccinated, you can come in as a test and go, which are requiring only one night accommodation and one time RT-PCR test. And also, you still need to have insurance for $20,000 cover minimum. Okay. And of course, one last thing that you need to do is the Thailand pass. As I mentioned, everyone still needs the Thailand pass, even Thai people. For this video, as mentioned, you don't need to change your Thailand pass if your plan has been changed and you're still traveling within 7 days. And this one is a new thing, only started from yesterday, 18th of April. Okay. The rest of the rule and regulation remain the same until the next change, which is after 22nd of April. And definitely, I will updating you after the 22nd of April. Everyone are waiting for after Mr. Pipat Ratchakitpakkan has made announced he will approach the CCSA about this plan that cancel test and go and cancel Thailand pass. So After the 22nd of April, I will share you this episode, this issue about this updating news. And I hope it will be a great news.
What about
for unvaccinated? For unvaccinated, you still can enter to Thailand by using alternative quarantine, which requirement need to be 5 nights staying in quarantine. And you still need to have RT-PCR test. Lately, the Thai government has canceled a few things. Don't be confused. They canceled RT-PCR test before your departure, 72 hours, okay? And now, your Thailand pass, you don't need to change if you're still traveling within 7 days, okay? Don't mix up with RT-PCR test on day one and still remain. So make it clear, 1 night quarantine, 1 time RT-PCR test. Thailand pass still existing, and the insurance is 20,000. If you want to check with our package, welcome to check at that link below that I have given to you, or in all different packages with the different type of hotel and the price. And from now on, and we also have the tours available. We have a good feedback also about the tours that request, because now we getting a environment and vibe of, we getting start the vibe of traveling. When the guests enter Thailand now, they are become a real tourist. Before, it was more like an expat, and the people are, most of you are visiting your family in here. But now we start to have a request for a real tourist, and welcome to Thailand. And if you're just meeting my, you know, first time, please don't forget to subscribe and sharing this content to your friend. And if you like this video, just give me some like. Thank you for watching, so you will not miss any episode that I sharing the most update about traveling to Thailand. Thank you for watching, and see you in my next video. Bye bye.